Live from Broadway, the Great White Way, part of the world's most exciting city, New York. It's time for the 50th annual broadcast of New Year's Eve with Guy Lombardo's Royal Canadians. Sponsored by Polaroid, inventors of instant pictures and new instant movies. And by Comtrex, the new multi-symptom cold reliever. Tonight's special guest stars are Kelly Garrett and Cab Calloway, with a special guest appearance by Kenny Gardner, and at Times Square, Lee Jordan. And now, from the world-famous Waldorf Astoria Hotel on fashionable Park Avenue, where New York's glamorous high society is celebrating New Year's Eve in the Grand Ballroom, it's Guy Lombardo's Royal Canadians. Ladies and gentlemen, Bill Lombardo.
Thank you, Dad. Well, thank you, everyone, and welcome to our 50th annual show, the longest-running television show in broadcasting history. And my father, Liebert, here has been part of every one of them. Tonight, once again, our friends will be watching on CBS television and coast-to-coast in Canada. But let's get us on our way right now from a song that sounded great in the 30s, and it still sounds good today. Here's Babyface.
Special guest stars Kelly Garrett and Cab Calloway will appear right after midnight on New Year's Eve with Guy Lombardo's Royal Canadian.
Mine does more.
Mine does more.
My side of the medicine chest has a lot of things for a cold that can relieve nasal and sinus congestion, sneezing, aches, pains, fever.
Well, my side does more because I've got Comtrex, the new multi-symptom cold reliever. Comtrex even relieves your cough. So all by itself, it gives more kinds of relief than Dristan or Contac or Bayer. For your miserable combination of all these symptoms, this is better. New Comtrex, in tablet or liquid.
Now you look through here and you squeeze, okay? Hurry up. Now just drop it in and come over here. This is Polavision, Polaroid's instant movies.
No, you're crazy.
Can you imagine how this would go over at your house?
You have won $125,000 in the Publishers Clearinghouse giveaway.
Thank you so much.
You go right ahead and shed those tears.
You may be lucky, too. Watch your mail for the new triple sweepstakes from Publishers Clearinghouse. Three great giveaways with three grand prizes. Three full sets of prizes only from Publishers Clearinghouse. So enter now. Maybe you'll say,
I never knew there was this much money in the whole world.
He feels so rotten when he gets the 24-hour bug, chills, pains, and stomach upset and diarrhea. This is what we have for the chills and pains. But for the upset and common diarrhea, we have Pepto Bismol. Do you get what he gets when you get the bug? Well, then get Pepto Bismol before you get the bug, because you won't want to go out and get it when you got it.
Well, don't go away now, folks. We've got a lot more action here. But let's go to Times Square right now and Lee Jordan. Take it away, Lee.
Thank you, Bill. It's a wet night in Times Square, but a mild one. The temperature is 48 degrees. The humidity is 96%. And it's been raining very hard over here. But I don't think the rain has dampened the enthusiasm of this crowd, although it may be somewhat smaller than it was last year when we had better weather. They've turned out, as they always have on New Year's Eve in Times Square, ever since New Year's Eve of 1905, when the New York Times first had its big fireworks display at the foot of its new building to celebrate the buildings being constructed that year. But they've come out to say farewell to 1978 and a big hello again to 1979. I see signs from Louisville where they're watching this on WHAS-TV. See signs from Buffalo where they're watching this on Channel 4. And from Columbus, Ohio, where they're watching this on WBNS. There's the electric ball that will be lowered just a minute before midnight. It's 6 feet in diameter, has 182 lights on it, and just a minute before midnight, that ball will start its descent down a 100-foot flagpole atop the New York, now called the number one Times Square building, down the 100-foot flagpole to enter 1979 at the foot of that flagpole. But they're saying goodbye to 1978 right now, which was a year of heavy snow, the heaviest snow in 10 or 11 years fell on Times Square here. Last January the 12th, we had 12 inches of snow, more than 13 inches in February. And something heavier than snow fell on Canada's Northwest Territory on the 24th of January, a radioactive Russian satellite. But spring brought the big stock market rally to Wall Street, and Steve Cawthon in sports rode a fern through the triple crown of racing to become the American Teenager of the Year at age 18. Disco dancing was the big rage in 1978, and Grease was the runaway hit movie at the box office last summer, as several youngsters saw it many times. The first test tube baby was born in 1978. In the late summer, Pope Paul passed away, to be succeeded by Pope John Paul, who reigned just 34 days as the Smiling Pope. He was the first non-Italian pope in centuries, followed John Paul II. And of course, now, as New Year's Eve is coming in, President Carter has announced we'll have full diplomatic relations with mainland China, which Canadians have had since 1971. I'll have something special to tell you about that happened 99 years ago tonight in 1879 when we come back to Times Square just before midnight. Now back to Bill Lombardo.
Thank you, Lee, and we'll be returning to Times Square a little later. But right now, here's Ty Lemdy to sing about Big Bad Leroy Brown.
The Terrys won $100,000 from Publishers Clearing House. Listen.
My wife's French, and she loves to cook. So what was the first thing she did with the money?
Built myself this beautiful kitchen.
You may be lucky, too. Watch your mail for the new Clearing House Triple Sweepstakes. Three great giveaways with three grand prizes. Three full sets of prizes. Homes, cars, cash. Only from Publishers Clearing House. So open this letter and enter now.
This is a good place for a stick-up.
This is a good place for a stick-up.
This is a good place for a stick-up.
Phew! This is a good place for a stick-up.
This is a stick-up. The invisible air deodorizer from Airwick. Airwick stick-ups are so small and concentrated, you hide them in small spaces where odors hide.
This is a good place for a stick-up.
A surprising message to Rolaids users. Tums neutralizes one-third more acid than Rolaids. Watch this familiar demonstration. One Rolaids and one Tums tablet are added to stomach acid. Both neutralize the acid. But on those occasions, when your stomach has even this much more excess acid, Tums can still absorb it. Rolaids can't. Because tablet for tablet, Tums neutralizes one-third more acid than Rolaids. For acid indigestion and heartburn, take Tums.
It's a new dial morning, and you're up and feeling new. It's a clean dial morning, and that clean belongs to you. There's a new day dawning, and your best is showing through.
Starting out clean, starting out dial, starting out new.
There's no cleaner way to start a new day than Dial soap, with deodorant protection that gets you so clean you feel your best.
Starting out clean, starting out dial, starting out new.
Don't scratch that dry skin. You'll make it worse.
But I've loaded it with lotion, and it still itches.
You need new Lanacane Medicated Dry Skin Lotion. It's the only dry skin lotion with an itch-stopping anesthetic. Its doctor-proven anesthetic works fast to stop painful itching. Then its antibacterials and rich moisturizers permit healing of red, cracked skin.
The itching's gone, and my skin's so soft and smooth.
Lanacane Medicated Lotion, the only one with an itch-stopping anesthetic.
5 years ago, I was the only one I knew using Grecian Formula to keep the gray out of my hair. But now there are millions. If you're trying to decide about using Grecian, listen to a few of them.
The change was so gradual and looked so natural, no one ever noticed.
My hair turned the same medium brown it used to be.
It's as easy to use as water.
I left a little gray on the sides.
My hair is back to the sandy color it used to be.
Grecian Formula, used by over 2 million men.
I'll bet a lot of your friends are using Grecian and you don't even know it.
The witching hour is closely approaching. For a look at what's happening in Times Square, let's go to Lee Jordan.
And we're just a couple of minutes away now from the moment when that ball will start its descent down into the new year. And we're marking the occasion tonight of a great event in mankind's story. It was just 29 years ago tonight that Thomas Alva Edison made the first public demonstration of the electric light bulb at his laboratory in Menlo Park, New Jersey. This is a replica of that little bulb. He had 34 of them to show the people who turned up by the thousands that night to see the electric light bulb for the first time. The electric light came to New York in 1880 and began its march up Broadway, 1881, 2, 3, and 4, and by 1884, the electric lights had reached Times Square. Looking at this little bulb that Edison created so long ago, 99 years ago, it's hard to compare it with the giant signs of the day because it's so dwarfed by it. But that's the way it began 99 years ago tonight. And when the giant electric ball begins its descent into 1979, we will start the first century of the electric light, the celebration of the new year in Times Square. And on this 50th anniversary of the broadcast by Guy Lombardo and his Royal Canadians, I'm reminded that 2 years ago, Guy told me about the chairman of CBS, William S. Paley, personally inviting him to go on the air 50 years ago when he came to New York with his band for the first time. And of course, the broadcast has continued on through this year and on into time. And so as we notice this 50th anniversary of the Lombardo broadcast, we note too that Mr. Paley also put Bing Crosby on the air for the first time in his own series. Frank Sinatra in his own series for the first after he left Tommy Dorsey. Edward R. Murrow and Lucille Ball for the first time on TV. Mr. Chairman, you sure can pick 'em. But here's the crowd out tonight in Times Square as we speak to you from the marquee of Mann's National Theater, and they wait to greet the new year with you throughout the USA and in Canada and all around the world. Give my regards to Washburn, Maine, reads one song. Holbrook, Massachusetts, reads another. Kappa Delta Phi is another. And now the electric ball has begun its descent into 1979 down the 100-foot flagpole from the 24th floor of the number one Times Square building. When the ball reaches the bottom of the flagpole just a second before 1979, it'll be lighted, the sign reading 1979 by Mrs. Alex Parker, wife of the owner of the building of number one Times Square. And now from Times Square, Lee Jordan, to all of you in the USA and across Canada, Happy New Year!